ओके, वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर फॉर एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च केस स्टडी. ओके, फोर्थ यूनिट. ओके, सो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च केस स्टडी एंड सम ऑपरेशंस बिहाइंड द दिस केस स्टडीज, हाउ टू गेट द एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च ऑन द अवेलेबल डाटा. ओके, देन आई विल शो एनोवा रिलेटेड टूल्स इन एक्सेल. Okay, so you can also perform your empirical research using ANOVA, using Excel. So let's start with our topic, empirical research case study. So objective is we learned already about the basics of empirical research. Okay, and we know the several concepts related to this, like testable question formulation, experiment design, data collection and statistical analysis of data. Okay, and now here we illustrate the concepts, okay, using a case study. So for example, suppose you want to study the application of eye tracking technology to text entry, okay, typing through eye case. Okay, you initiate an empirical inquiry to explore the performance limits and capabilities of various feedback modalities for keys in on-screen keyboards used with eye typing. Okay, so suppose four feedback modalities are considered by you: audio only, click visual, speech visual and visual only. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे एक method है, ठीक है, eye tracking technology to text entry. So through eye gaze, typing is performed. Okay, and there are performance limit also and capabilities of various feedback modalities, okay, for keys in on-screen keyboard, okay, used with eye typing. So steps in empirical research. Okay, so classical view, so there are four steps you can see here. First, observe and describe a phenomena. Okay, then second, formulate an hypothesis to explain it. Okay, then third, use the hypothesis to predict or describe other phenomena. Then fourth, perform experiment to test hypothesis. Okay, for this you have to know about the hypothesis theory, hypothesis testing. Okay, so go and search about hypothesis testing on Google, so you will get the information. And there are two types of hypothesis testing: null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. So we will not discuss this hypothesis testing here. Okay, but there are some point you can see here in bold. Okay, so first is phenomena, so an interaction between an human and a computer technology. Okay, then hypothesis, research question set. Okay, then predict and describe, so predict, predictive model, and then describe, descriptive model. And other phenomena are other interactions. Okay, and in fourth, experiment, user study. Okay, so we will see more about the process. Okay, in four steps. So steps, first phase one. Okay, so the prototype. Okay, so steps 1, 2, 3. Okay, according to previous slide, you can see here 1, 2, 3. Okay, so starting with a basic idea. Okay, think, analysis, model, create, choose. Okay, then build prototype. Okay, then test, measure and compare. Okay, so all these are process are iterative, so iterations are frequent and unstructured and intuitive and informed. Okay, so research questions take shape here. Okay, and certain measurable aspects of interaction suggest, like test condition and task for empirical inquiry, also have identified here. Then in phase second, the user study. Okay, first build apparatus, integrate prototype and test condition into experimental apparatus and software. Okay, you have to build a device. Okay, then experiment design, tweak software, establish experimental variables, procedure, design, run pilot of subject. Okay, you have to define all this in experiment design. Then user study, collect data, conduct interview. Okay, in groups. Okay, then analyze data, build models, check for significant differences, etc. in an this step. Then next, iteration. Okay, so again the steps are repeated. Okay, so the user study. Now So describe the participant employed for your study. Okay, so there are 13 all volunteers recruited from the university campus. Age, gender, computer experience, eye tracking, typing experience. Okay, then apparatus is describe hardware and software. Okay, what type of device you use here, you have to describe here. Then experiment design, you decided to have a 4x4 repeated measure design. Okay, there are two independent variables with four levels. Okay, so here feedback modality with the levels ACSV, four levels. Okay, and the participants were asked to enter blocks of text at a time, and four such blocks were there for each participant. Okay, so block is a factor with four levels, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we will see some data related to this. So here next is experiment design, and you have identified dependent variables, measures, okay, like speed of text entry in words per minute, then accuracy of text entry in percentage of characters in error, then key selection activity in key strokes per character, and also responses to broad questions. Okay, and then order of conditions like feedback modality order deferred for each participant using a Latin square method. Okay, so it is also useful to know that about Latin square method. So again, go for and research about this Latin square method, so you will know the actual process of this feedback modality order. Okay, so the topic is not related to this, so we will go further for our case study. So procedure for data collection. Okay, so you first explain to the participants the general objective of the experiment. Okay, then the eye tracking apparatus was calibrated, and the participants were put through some practice trials for familiarization. Okay, and afterwards you begin data collection. So there is the procedure for data collection. So first phrases of text presented to be participants by experimental software. Okay, then participants instructed to enter phrases as quickly and accurately as possible. Then five phrases were entered by the participants per block. Then total number of phrases entered in experiments is equal to 13 into 4 into 4 into 5 is equal to 1040. Okay, as per the available participants and entries. Okay, so now experiment replication. Okay, it is important. Okay, so this description of the experimental methodology like participant selection, apparatus, design procedure must be sufficient to allow the experiment to be replicated by other researchers, so they can make a different study. Okay, and this is necessary to allow the possibility of the results to be verified or refuted. Okay, if you have some detail or methodology or data, you have to share with other researchers so they can verify your model. Okay, and an experiment that can not be replicated is useless, because you have to repeatedly test that experiment again and again for verification. Then data tables. Okay, so next slide contains example data on text entry speed recorded in study. Okay, so first create a table to arrange data. So I will show this operations of empirical research using Excel. Okay, some not completely same, but some different and easy. Okay, because there is some tools available for data analysis in Excel. Okay, so first create a table to arrange data. Okay, from the table calculate other quantities such as grand mean. Okay, 6.96 word per minute. Okay, tables also allow you to make silent observation. Okay, for example, fourth block speed for best condition. Okay, and then here you can see the data. Okay, you can also collect this data, or you can make your own data. Okay, or you also copy this data for your, okay, but you have to some modification in values. Okay, so here you can see the data available in this slide. Okay, there are factors and levels. Okay, I will show some simple data. Already we have discussed in previous lecture. So using that data, I will show the ANOVA process. Okay, here. So factors and levels. Then outliers explained here is the point, or you can say value, different from other points. Okay, most of the points are nearby, but single or more than one value is outside the range, or a different long you can say long distance from the other points. So it is called as outlier. Okay, then here you can see each cell is the mean for five phases as of input. Okay, so according to this data, the data recorded in tables are analyzed statistically to identify statistically significant effects. Okay, so for this, using this example, you may have to following findings, like main effects for feedback mode significant. Okay, so F is equal to 8.77 and P is less than equal to 0.005, and again feedback mode by block interaction not significant, so F is equal to 0.767. okay, then data table, apart from the main table, other tables also created, and which helps in making more useful observation. Okay, so here next slide shows the summary table created for the data on text entry speed. So here is the next next data table. Okay, so here you can see speed, feedback mode, block, audio only, click plus visual, speech plus visual, and visual only. And then for each entry, each block, there is mean calculated according to the available data. Okay, so in fourth block, you can see each cell is the mean for 13 participants. Okay, then 5.7% faster on fourth block, you can see 7.55 and 7.14. okay, so it gives some meaningful information here. Then you can make your chart or graph, so I will show also this. Okay, how to create the chart using Excel. Okay, and it is also useful to learn about data science using Excel, so that will create the concept, clear your concept related to machine learning if you want to study data and data science and analytics. Okay, so create graphs and chart to visualize findings. Okay, so here you can see the chart. Okay, so it is related to audio only, click plus visual, speech plus visual, and visual only. Okay, I will show you simple chart. Okay, bar chart, you can make different charts also. So the broad question, along with the data analysis, an empirical study typically collects direct feedback from the participants on broad questions. Okay, like example, participants can be asked about their preferences, satisfaction levels, or even their suggestions for improvement. Okay, and in here study, you ask the participant to rank between 1 to 4 the feedback mode based on personal preferences. Okay, and then you obtain the following result, like 6 of 13 participants gave a first place ranking to the fastest feedback modality. Then again, the results obtained is not strong enough to come to any conclusion. Okay, so a reason may be that differences just weren't large enough for participants to really tell the difference in overall performance. If you have short differences or small differences, okay, there is so the experiment is meaningless. Okay, but you have some difference, or you can say significant difference, then you can say your experiment is good. Okay, in case of overall performance. Okay, so there is the important part of such differences, significant differences. Okay, so however, you have also made another observations. Okay, namely 10 of the 13 participants gave a first or second place ranking to the fastest feedback modality. So this can be treated as a strong indication that better performance yield a better preference rating. Okay, this is the conclusion of this other observation. Then what is the missing here? Okay, so case study just describes so that the user study involves collection, analysis of usage data, as well as participants' feedback. Okay, but it that's not all. Okay, it misses an important aspects of empirical research. Okay, like there is no theoretical account of the phenomena. Okay, in this research, then there is no delineation, description, categorization of known and observed behavior. Okay, that can form such a theoretical account, okay, and it is not sufficient to simply observe and conclude. It is also necessary to theorize about the observation, okay. So you have to identify the why the text entry speed is the least in particular feedback mode, okay. Then direct conclusion from observation helps us decide an interaction method. A theory about the observed behavior can help us do much more, okay, for again next experiment, okay. And such theories can eliminate need for further investigation as well as can suggest ways for improvement, okay. Then empirical research in SCI means you such theories or refoundings are another motivations for conducting empirical research in SCI, okay. And there are many models available in SCI for this derived empirically research methodology, okay. And then the case form the model, like here there is a model of interaction suggested by the observation in the case study, okay. And here one possibility, all gauge points changes were logged as events, okay. And was what was the total number of such events are there categories of such events. Again you have to calculate about some this case study, okay, about events and number of such events, okay, and categorize those events. Then identification and labeling and tabulation of such could form the basis of a model of interaction for I typing, okay. So this is all about the case study, okay. So using this you can also perform task on your data, available data, or you can make your data own and then you can perform these actions, okay, for such an experiment, okay, for theoretical as well as practical, okay. So I will show you methods for ENOVA, okay. So this is all about the case study, and already we have discussed about ANOVA methodology, okay, in previous lecture. So I will show in Excel, okay. So I have the Excel related to LibreOffice, okay, you can see here, okay. And I have taken this data, okay. Here you can see participants, your method, multi-tap and T9. So already we have discussed in ANOVA, okay. So we have a data like here, so I have used this data, okay. Then I have done ANOVA testing, ANOVA steps, okay, for this data, okay. So here is the calculated, okay, we have calculated, identified this calculations, different calculations performed in ANOVA, okay, statistical calculations, okay. So you have to also know the statistics methods to calculate this mean, mode and deviations, okay, standard deviation or variance, okay. So simply I have data, okay, you know the data, you have the slides, okay. Then I use if you are using Microsoft Excel, then you have different options for data analysis or something. So I don't know, but in here LibreOffice, here is the data option, okay. And then there is the statistics, okay. So there are different you can see here, okay, statistical methods to test your data, okay. So here is the ANOVA, okay. So first I have performed descriptive statistics, okay. So the results is here, you can see in second sheet, okay. I have calculated mean, standard, okay, standard error, mode, median, okay, first quartile, third quartile, variance, standard deviations, kurtosis, skewness, range, minimum, maximum, okay, then sum and count, okay, according to the sheet 1 data, okay. I have selected this and like here you can select, then I have go, then I selected this descriptive statistics and apply some, like here you can give, I given the next sheet information here, okay. So here is the sheet 1 input range, so I have taken this output in second sheet, okay. So I have written here like here dollar sheet 2 dot dollar a dollar 1, okay. After this, if you, and again you can grouped by column and rows, okay. So you can go for column also and for row also. Okay. So okay, using this column method, there is the column 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So means and other statistical calculations are calculated here. Okay. So this is descriptive. Okay. So again I have go to for ANOVA. So I have selected like here. Okay. Then used this data option for statistics, and then I have pressed here analysis of variance ANOVA. Okay. So here again there is the input range from the sheet 1, and again I given sheet 3 for ANOVA results. Okay. And you can go also for type single factor and two factor. Okay. Then grouped by columns and rows. Okay. Then parameters like alpha 0.05. Okay. And then other options. So if you give output here $seat3 dot $A$1, then the OK pressed, then you will get the result in sheet 3. Okay. So I will show another two factor related data. So first we will see the sheet 3 data. Okay. So after analysis of variance by single factor, we will get the single factor ANOVA single factor. Okay. Alpha 0.05. Then I we get the results like group, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. Okay. Then count, sum, mean and variance. Okay. According to column, then source of variations. Okay. SS, DF, MS, F value, P value and F critical. For this you have to study some hypothesis testing related methods and theory, statistics related method and theory. Okay. And some probabilities related theories, okay, to understand this F and P value, okay, F critical and MS, DF and SS, okay. So then between groups there are values for F, P value, and okay, within groups also here, and then total values. For again for this output data I have selected this for getting this graph. Okay, so for graph simply I click here. Okay. Sorry, 1 minute. I go here. Okay. Then I selected in case of your Microsoft Excel you have a different option. Okay. So simply I forgot one 1 minute. Okay. I have selected from here. Okay. This one. First select your values to be plotted. Okay. And then you have to insert chart. Okay. Then you will get this picture or visualized data. Okay. So you can identify the meaningful information from this visualized information. Okay. So here you can see between groups, within groups and total. Okay. So I will show you by two factor again. So first I will make a sheet. Okay. Sheet 4. Okay. Then I will go to my data. Okay, I select the data, then go to data, then for this I go to statistics, then use this ANOVA, then I type for output here, you can see, okay, sheet 4, okay, dot dollar, okay, dollar A, then dollar 1. So you can also get the output on same sheet, but I use other sheets for simplicity. Okay, now I use type 2 two factor. Okay. Okay, using two factors already they grouped by default normally used for both I think column and rows. Okay, so alpha is for 0.05. okay, so using two factor there is no need of columns and rows. Okay, by default it takes the column and rows according to two factor. Okay, so simply I place press here okay. Okay, so simply it calculate and gives the result here sheet 4. Okay, so there are some different you can say values here according to column and because it takes by default column and rows. Okay, using two factor. Okay, so simply I will plot this output. Okay, first select here, then I make the chart. Okay, so simple I use column related. Okay, or I can use hereby. So I think I will go for scatter. Okay, so using scatter I will show you detail. Okay, so simply set this. Okay, next. So for first chart type, then data range. Okay, then data series. Okay, so I am not selecting here data series in rows. Okay, already selected data series in column. Okay, so only one is selected here. So for then go next. Okay, then data series options. Okay, so x and y. So simply I am going for y value. Okay, then next there is a title, so I will type here. Okay, simple ANOVA 2-factor. Okay, ANOVA 2-factor. Okay, so I select again here x axis. Okay, already y axis is selected. Then finish. Okay, you can also select display legends like left, right, top, bottom. Okay, so simply, okay, you got the chart related to this data. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so simple to analyze your data using Excel. Okay, there is no need of specific tools or programming. Okay, but in case of machine learning you have to learn some statistics methods, mathematics, okay, probabilities, and Python language. Okay, to plot or experiment with your data. Okay, so that's all about our case studies, related study, and ANOVA. Okay, so now class is over here. Okay, the lecture is over here. So okay, 1 minute I will okay, so class, lecture is complete here. Thank you.